Welcome to the Fluid and Particle Mechanics Lab. Today in this classroom by Dr. K.S. Rajmohan sir, we are going to talk about the experiment on pressure drop in a PEG bed column. So Mr. Yashwant is going to talk about the details of the experiment. Mr. Yashwant, over to you.
Good morning students, welcome to the FPM laboratory. So today we'll be demonstrating the experiment of pressure drop across a PEG bed. So the objective of this experiment is to obtain the pressure drop for the flow of water against the PEG bed, and then we will verify the obtained pressure drop using theoretical equations like Ergun equation.
Dear students, welcome to the theory part of this experiment, determination of the pressure drop across a PEG bed. Now, as you see here, the fluid flowing through a PEG bed, we know that there are many unit operations which involves the fluid to flow through different systems and which is filled with particle materials. Okay. Now, these particle materials could be either porous solids or it could be structured packing. When we talk about structured packings, these are actually specially designed materials which are used for various unit operations, which could be extraction and absorption process or even in distillation process. Now, the structured packings consist of thin corrugated metal plates that allow the fluid to flow through some complicated pathways, as a result of which it allows more surface area which will be available for the mass transfer to take place. Now, these structured packings also are used in portions of distillation columns containing only structured packings are not uncommon, in fact, in the chemical process industry nowadays. Now, in case of porous solids, this could be used as a support for catalytic metals. And again, in case of structured packings, it involves the mass transfer across physical interfaces. Now, this interfaces could be gas liquid interface or it could be liquid liquid interface. Then from the process design point of view, the major concern is to actually develop a column with a pressure difference which will be maintained along the whole length of the material bed. Now, while scaling up of such a column, the most difficult challenging situation that a design engineer could confront is the maintenance of this pressure difference. Now, this pressure difference, we could even use some prototype packed columns, but in that case we might see that it gives us a larger pressure difference than predicted by the scaling procedure. Either large pumps or compressors must be available in the chemical process, or the column must be emptied and refilled with the material particles to maintain this pressure difference. Now, this type of use might only involve and incur a lot of cost into the whole process. So the later option is actually not that good enough. So how do we estimate the pressure difference then? So to tackle this issue, in 1952, Sabri Ergun, he published an equation that has been used for scaling packed columns. So its purpose was to explain the transition zone between the laminar flow regime and the turbulent flow regime through the same mass of material particle. So when we plot a function of the pressure drop against the Reynolds number, we see that a negative slope line for fluid flowing at low Reynolds number and a horizontal line for fluid flowing at high Reynolds number is achieved. So we describe the former flow regime to be the laminar flow regime and the later flow regime to be the turbulent flow regime. It is also seen that the region between the laminar flow regime and the turbulent flow regime contains the transition flow regime. So theoretically, the two flow regimes should make a sharp obtuse interaction. Now, after this, we will learn about the Ergun equation. Now, as I said, the Ergun equation depends on the different types. Okay, so it depends on the different conditions. So these are the height of the bed, then the viscosity or the density of the fluid which is being considered, then the diameter of the particle and also the voidage. Okay, so and then it also depends on the superficial velocity. Now when we talk about the superficial velocity, we mean that it is that velocity that allows the phase or the fluid or the gas phase to flow through the cross-sectional area without even considering the solid material. So it is basically a hypothetical or artificial velocity. Okay, so this Ergen equation can also be written in this form as given below. So here the voidage, this voidage also known as the fraction void volume of bed, is given by volume of the void divided by the volume of the total bed. Now what is this voidage? Voidage is nothing but the empty space present in the material. Now this voidage can vary from 0 to 1 depending on the type of the porous material used. Okay, so this equation we need to use to find out the voidage, and ultimately in putting it into the Ergen equation we can find out the pressure drop across the packed column. The detailed explanation of packed towers and plate columns and the packing materials which are used in a packed bed column, also the different types of plate columns which are available, the differentiation between the packed bed column and the plate column, and also the channeling, flooding and loading points in a packed bed tower has been explained in detail by Dr. K.S. Rajmohan sir in the lecture 28 of packed towers, which you need to refer to.
So this is the experimental setup for pressure drop through a packed bed we have. So essentially the major part of this equipment is we are having a packed bed column which is made up of a glass, cylindrical glass column, so which is filled with some packing materials, and both ends are attached to the pipeline. So we have a pipeline of different diameter. So how water will be flowing across it and how much water will be flowing across this column, we have to measure the volumetric flow rate, we have a rotometer attached to it. So your rotometer is a variable area volumetric flow rate measuring device. So we can adjust the volume, how much water is flowing across this column, using a valve. So we have a control valve here. So by adjusting the valve position, we can keep a different volumetric flow rate in this. So the flow rate can be adjusted by changing the valve position, and we will be maintaining, like you can see here, it is liters per minute. So we can keep 2 liters per minute, 5 liters per minute, 10 liters, 15 liters or 20 liters per minute. So like that we can change the volumetric flow rate. For each flow rate, what is the pressure drop across this column can be measured. So you can see that at the both end, at the top, at the bottom of the column, there is an opening. So this opening is connected, it's a pressure opening. So similarly at the top of the column we have an opening. So this is all, these both ends, that is across this column, what is the pressure drop can be measured by connecting these two openings to a manometer. So through connecting tubes, we connect that to a U-tube manometer which is filled with mercury. You have a scale attached to it. So for each volumetric flow rate that we keep, we are going to measure, note down what is the flow rate in this rotometer, then we will note down the pressure drop across this column by what is the height in the left limb and what is the height in the right limb. Then we will make use of the equations to calculate the pressure drop across the packed bed. So this is the equipment. Actually, to supply water to this equipment, we have a collection tank. This serves as collection tank as well as the reservoir. So water is completely filled with this. So we have a pump. We have a pump at the bottom which will withdraw water from this tank. So this pump will be supplying water, and that water is flowing through this packed bed through this valve. Okay, so we are adjusting this valve, we are adjusting the volumetric flow rate. So what is the volumetric flow rate? How do you know? Here we have no need of collecting the water in this like other experiments. Directly we will get what is the actual discharge.
We know that a rotometer will contain a float which will be moving across between, because due to flow it will be trying to push the float up. Due to gravity it will try to come down, so there will be a balance and it will take a position at equilibrium. So from the graduated scales available in the rotometer, we will be able to directly measure the flow rate in LPM.
Then what we will note down? We will note down what is the pressure drop across this column by noting down the what is the mercury level in the left limb as well as what is the mercury level in the right limb. So thereby we will take 5 to 6 readings in this experiment. Once we switch on the pump, we will keep this valve in different position. We will be doing 5 readings. Okay, so first it is closed position, means if it is closed position, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So like that 5 different positions, what we will do, we will be measuring the liters per minute of volumetric flow rate. What is the position of this throat? We will note down the 5 readings. For each position that we keep, definitely there will be pressure drop across this packed bed, right? So which can be measured using this manometer. Okay, so we have a scale here. So once you keep a position, once I switch on, water will be flowing. I will be noting down what is the volumetric flow rate in liters per minute. So once I do that, what is the pressure drop across this packed bed will be noted down using this YouTube manometer. So in the left limb and right limb, whatever is the mercury level, we will be noting down from the scale. For example, if I switch on, it will take a position here and it will go up. So there I will note down the values. So like that, we are going to keep this valve in 5 different positions and note down 5 different LPM values and 5 different left hand side value and right hand side value in the YouTube manometer. So then we will theoretically verify the pressure drop using the calculation and procedures. Okay.
So here we have a collection tank which is filled with water. So this water is pumped using a pump which is present here. So the pump will pump the water from the collection tank into this packed bed. So this packed bed is filled with Rashik rings, and which is completely filled in the glass tube, and this glass tube is having two coverings in the upper and the lower, which is used to measure the pressure drop, which is connected to the manometer. So this manometer will tell us the reading we can adjust the reading by changing the flow rates of the rotameter. So this rotameter is controlled by having a control valve which controls the amount of water which is pumped into the packed bed. So this water level will be measured by a float which is present in the rotameter, and this float measures the water flow rate in terms of liters per minute LPM. And here you have the graduations at 5, 10, 15 and 20. So by changing the control valve, you can control the amount of water flowing into the packed bed, and corresponding to every flow rate, we measure the manometer reading. So if it is 5 LPM, we have a manometer reading, and 10 LPM, another manometer reading, 15 and 20. So like that, we control the water flow rate and we measure the corresponding pressure difference across the packed bed. So now let us perform the experiment. So we'll be switching on the experiment. Switching on. Yeah. So now the pump is switched on and we have the water flowing to the packed bed. You can see the water flowing. So the water started flowing to the packed bed. So now we'll be controlling the water flow rate using the control valve here. So you see there's a float changing its position. So by seeing the float position, we can see the amount of flow rate in terms of LPM. So the control valve we use to control the float position, which will tell you the flow rate of the water inside the packed bed. So you see the float position is now is slowly moving. So we'll try the first reading now. So the float is positioned at 2 LPM.
5.
Okay. 5 LPM. So by the 5 LPM, we have a pressure drop difference in the manometer. So we take the reading at 5 LPM, the manometer reading, which is the left hand and the right hand. And then So it is corresponding 1.6. And the right hand. So we measure the manometer reading by using the measuring scale, which is graduated. And so we tell the corresponding pressure drop across the packed bed. So now we have the flow rate at 5 LPM. And the manometer reading, the left hand reading is 16 and right hand is 14. So similarly, we will be changing the flow rate again by changing the control valve. So now we will slowly open the control valve. Now we have reached around 10 LPM. So now the reading at 10 LPM will be noted by measuring the pressure drop. So at 10 LPM the rotameter is fixed. And now we have a pressure drop change. You can see the change in the pressure drop. So you see the left hand side is at graduated at 18.5 and the right hand side is graduated at around 12. So it's around 11 points. So now similarly you can see for increase by increasing the flow rate. Now we have increased it to 15. So now at 18 we have the maximum flow rate and here you see the pressure drop having a large difference. So here in the left hand side now it has reached 24.5 and the right hand side it is reached around 8.5. So we have selected the readings of the manometer at 18 LPM. So this is the float and this is the manometer reading. From the experiment, we have got the observation table. So observation table will consist of the flow rate and the left hand side manometer reading and the right hand side manometer reading. So using these observations which we collected, so we have the calculation table which has the volumetric flow rate which is in meter cube per second, then we have the manometer reading in meters, then we have the mass velocity, and then we have the change in the pressure drop, and then the Reynolds number is calculated, then the fanning friction factors. So using this, we have the formulas present for the Reynolds number, for the fanning friction factors, and the fanning friction factor using the Ergun equations. So these all formulas will be used to calculate the fanning friction factor. And then we use these factors to plot a graph. The graph would be log of fanning friction factor versus log of the Reynolds number. So using this plot, we obtain the data on the pressure drop, which is verified with theoretical equations. Coming to the results and discussion, so now after we obtained the log-log plots of Reynolds number and the fanning friction factor, we make a plot of them and then we conclude by obtaining the data on the pressure drop, and the data which is calculated using theoretical equation is verified with the experimental pressure drop which we have got. So that will be the conclusion of this experiment. Okay, dear students, we have performed the experiment. So now we have collected the data by performing the experiment. And this is the obtained data that we have collected. So this is on the screen, the flow rate, the manometer reading in the left limb, R1 centimeter, and the manometer reading in the right limb, R2 centimeter. Now we have obtained the experimental data from the experiment. So using this data, students, you can calculate the pressure drop, you can perform the calculations, and this calculation table has been explained. So you complete the calculations and you can submit the folder, and if you have any kind of doubts you can contact us.
So we have a packed bed, we have a YouTube manometer, we have a rotometer, we have a valve, and we have a collection tank. and we have a pump. So that makes us our apparatus, right? So this pump will supply the water to these packed beds. But before this water passes through the packed bed, it will pass through a rotometer. So what is rotometer? It is a flow measuring device. It's a variable area flow meter, which will consist of a throat. So based on the valve position, we are going to change the volumetric flow rate, right? So by varying the valve position, we will have different volumetric flow rate. So based on the volumetric flow rate, this throat will take a position. Either it will be down if it is low flow rate, it will be take a position up if it is higher volumetric flow rate. So here we need not do any collection thing and measuring the time taken for 5 centimeter rise kind of thing, because this type of flow meter gives us the reading directly without any calculations. So here we'll have scale is there. So this graduations is there. You can see it is 2, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20 unit is liters per minute of water. Okay. So directly we'll come to measure, you will able to measure the volumetric flow rate using this rotometer setup. So that's why we will not again measure collection tank, time taken for 5 centimeter rise, all that is not needed. Okay.
So dear students, today we had learned about the pressure drop across a peg bed. So we'll meet you again in the next experiment in another video. Thank you.
Laboratory, we have demonstrated you pressure drop across a packed bed. So in next video, we will meet you with another experiment in fluid and particle mechanics laboratory. Thank you so much for joining my classroom. Bye bye.
Thank you so much for joining our classroom. We'll meet you again in the next lecture. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye.